Power BI design tips. Hi, I'm M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. What are we going to learn in this video? We are going to see what are the 5 important tips to design a Power BI dashboard, how to design the Power BI report or dashboard using Power BI desktop. So before directly I talk to you about this Power BI dashboard, let me first tell you why this Power BI report or dashboard is required. When we are trying to understand some business, it is very difficult for us to understand it as part of a raw data. Now, what is meant by raw data? Raw data is nothing but the data which we receive it from the client. Either that might be from Excel sheet, either that might be from SQL server or from any other cloud platforms, whatever might be the data that client is giving us to us. So the point here is, when we are getting this data will be purely in a raw format. When I'm telling raw, it might be unorganized, it might be unstructured, many values might be missing, the data types might be wrong, okay, some wrong information will be misplaced in between the columns. So there are many such informations which will be happening. Now what are we going to do in Power BI? After we do the data transformation part, depending upon the client's requirement, we will be creating the visual. The raw data, we are converting into the visuals. What are we doing? We are converting the raw data into a pictorial format. We are converting a raw data into a visualization format. The reason that we are converting it in a visualization format is that whenever we are trying to see something in form of an image, in form of an animation, in form of a movement, then it is very easy to understand and we can remember it for a longer time. Let us consider a simple example of a movie, okay? If we get a script of a movie, is it really easy to understand the script of a movie, or is it really interesting to watch a movie and understand the concept of it? Are you getting my point? So the same concept is applicable here in Power BI also. Understanding a data which is in huge columns and rows, it is very difficult. What are we going to do? We are going to transform the data and convert it into a form of a pictures, in the form of a visuals. So that's where our Power BI report or dashboard will be helpful, as Power BI is the best reporting tool in the market, which is of a Microsoft product. So now what are we going to do? When we have this report or dashboard, a client or a customer might easily understand what exactly is their business, where are the flaws, okay, where they have to focus on to improve their business and so on. So now let me show you practically how we can create a report or a dashboard. And while I'm creating this design of a report, I will even tell you what all the key points or tips that you have to follow it so that you can make your report or dashboard so attractive. So let's work on it. So here I have a data. Now the point is that I'd have a blank page, which is a power view, this one. So here, step by step, I'm going to do the changes. So now, as you can see, the background color is completely in a white. If I want, I would like to change it in any other color. So let us change the background color first. So I'll go to format. In the format, you have canvas background. In this canvas background, as you can see, the background is white. You can change it to any other color that you wish to. So for example, if I choose this one, okay, so this is a canvas background. So now let me show you the wallpaper. This is the wallpaper. So now the wallpaper is also in a white color. Let me keep it in the same color like this. So my report is, my background of the wallpaper is changed. Okay, this is the first step. Now, any report that when we are preparing it, there should be some title, there should be some heading. For example, sales report or Amazon report or some info or HR analytics dashboard or something like this, right? So let us create that title first. So directly we cannot write title here. We have to use a text box image, okay? So here I am using this text box. And in this text box, I am writing the title called as report, a very simple thing. Now it is up to me. I have to do the formatting. So I'm just increasing the, I'm making it bold. Okay. So here I'm increasing the size to 36. All right. So I'm aligning it to the center and I'm making sure that it is in a top fin, in a top way. Okay. So here, in this text box also, as you can see, it is in a white color, the text is in black color, and the white color box has a square shaped curves, right? Now let me make some formatting for this one too. I'll select this one, I'll come to the format, okay, I'll go to size and style. As you can see, the background color, let me change the background color to this one, okay, this is looking good, and I'll add some borders to it, okay, and I'll make it in a rounded corners, some with 12 points. Okay, even if you want, you can even add a shadow for this one, but as it is a title one, I do not want to have a shadow for this. It is up to me. So now the report as a title is successfully completed. Now let us work on the important part of our particular report, which is the key information that you would like to show it to the client or customer. So what are those key points? So first let me take here total sales. In order to show the total sales, I have to choose a card chart. Okay, with card chart is used to show a specific key number. Am I right? So here what I'm doing, I am choosing the total sales, which I have it here in my data. So total sales, okay, I'm dragging it. So total sales is 196 units. So total sales, I have it here. I'll off this one and I will on the title. So title is nothing but total sales. Total sales. So here I'll make it to bold and I'll increase the font style to 16 and I'll make it in a white color so that I can make the background color black. Okay. And I'm aligning it to the center. So what I'm going to do, I'm also going to change the background color of this particular card, which is in a white color here, right? So if you want, you can even keep the same thing. If I would like to go, I can even go with the same part here. So 196 trillion, so this is what I have it here. So now what I'm doing, I'm just making sure that my the card chart corners are rounded. So that's where I'm coming here and I'm going to add the border. So with the rounded corners, 12 points as the same how we have chosen for the title, and I'm adding some shadow to show some interesting effects. Okay, so we can see that we have got one card chart. So now what I'm trying to do, I'm just copying it and pasting 2 to 3 new card charts so that I can show some multiple informations and I can save some time in order to do this particular design. Okay, so rather than choosing a new card chart, doing the formatting all the time, I'm just copying it and placing it so that I can change the information directly rather than changing or creating a new card chart. So in the place of total sales here, what I'm trying to do, I'll take the total profit. So this is a total profit. Now it's my duty to come and change the title. So I'll change it to total profit. Okay, I have got my total sales, I have got my total profit. Okay, so now the interesting part is what the next information I would like to show. So we have some research and development thing that we have done it here. I would like to show what, how much is the investment that has happened in the R&D. So that information I would like to show it here. So what I'm going to do, I'm just choosing this R&D investments here and I'm going to change the title to R&D investments. Okay, I'm going to change it here to R&D investments. So now what I'm even going to do, I'm just increasing the size of it, okay, so that it can be in one line or in one page. Okay, as you can observe that I am maintaining a proper space. Okay, alignment, this is the proper alignment, nowhere the card is up and down like this, in a proper alignment with the proper spaces that I'm giving it here. This is the first tip in a design. And the next one that I'm going to take is how much, even my company has given me the targets, so how much is my total targets, that also I would like to show it. Okay, so the total target that I would like to show it, so I'll remove this total sales and take the target here. So this is my target. I'll just go and change the title to total target. Okay, so my total target also I have received it. Now the very interesting part is that I should also show that for how many expenses I have got this much sales and for total how many expenses I have got this much profit. So for that also what I'm going to do, I'm just copying this existing card chart that I have prepared and I'm copying the new one. And what I'm trying to do here, I'm going to change it to total expenses. Okay, I'm dragging total expenses here. I'm changing the title to total expenses. Alright, so I have got the card charts information. Alright, my dear viewers, one thing you can see is that either you can put few visuals in page 1, few visuals in page 2 and prepare some 2 to 3, 4 pages of a report. Or many people, what they do, they increase the page size. How to increase the page size? If you go here in the format, okay, what's happening? We have some page information, right? And we have some canvas settings. See this, the existing one which you are seeing here till the dotted lines, it is 16:9. Either you can convert it into 4:3, or you can convert it into letter type, okay? Or you can convert it into a tooltip, or you can design your own size of it. So let me go with the default one, which is 16:9, and that I'm going to guide it to you. So if you want, you can increase or you can shape up your own page as per your convenience. So this is the first thing. So now, as you can see that we have got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 card charts. My dear viewers, whenever you are preparing some report or a dashboard, please make sure that you have the card charts and the slicers in your particular report or dashboard, because these are the visuals which will be helpful to make a very clear and easy understanding to the business when some client or customer is interacting with the report or dashboard. Okay, so now what I'm trying to do, I'm going to take some slicers. Okay, I'm going to take some slicers. So I'm adding some slicers here. I'm making sure that these are of the same alignment that I have. So here in the slicers, let me take some country, from which country, how much I have got. So I have chosen country here. I'll just format it so that I'll get it in the same way. I have just formatted it. Okay, so now add visual title. It is telling me to add some visual title. So rather than having this completely, I'll just go with the country. It is something called country, right? So even I'm going to change the style of it. Okay, even I'm going to change the style of it. It's a vertical list. I'll just go with the drop down so that if anyone is interacting, then they can directly click on this all and select whichever they want. Okay, so here what I'm doing, it is also very small. Now I'll just increase the size of it so that it will be very easy for us to go and understand or look into it. Okay, so the values that I have here, I'm just increasing it to bold and improve and making it to 16 so that it can be clearly visible. Okay, I'm adding the background or border, whatever it may be, we have it already here. So for example, if you would even like to add the border, okay, we can add the border to top, bottom, left or right for the one which I have it in my slicer. Alright, I will even add the background. If you want, you can add the background, it is up to you. Now if I talk about the slicer header, can you see something called as country inside the slicer? If I want, I can keep it, or as I have already kept a title, I'll just remove it. Okay, so this is all as simple as such. Now say this, my country list is clearly visible. If you are thinking that, okay, this is very small, the slicer is very small, then what I have to do, I have to again change my particular alignment. I should make sure that all the slicers probably should be having a same similar size, so that it looks very neat and attractive. Okay, so rather than having a small boxes, what I'm trying to do, I'm just increasing it to some same sizes so that it is very easy to understand and it looks good. It looks good also, attractive. Please do not make your report a rainbow, because rainbow color, because do not mix 7, 12, 15 colors in your particular report. That looks very awkward. Please maintain a proper some basic or themed one that will be very much clear to attractive for the client to look and understand. So this is one slicer I have considered. Even now what I'm doing, I'm copying it and I'm pasting it. Now I'm taking some another slicer here. So in this, in the place of country, now let me choose something called as company, from which company. Okay, I'll choose the company information as well. There are multiple companies that we have in our particular data set. So I have got country, I have got company as a slicers. Now if you would like to add, you can add some other slicer also. For as I have some space, what I'm trying to do, I'm just writing, creating one another slicer here, and I am choosing some other information. So let me choose the industrial sector, from which industry, how much expenses, how much sales we have got, that information also. In the place of country, let me write industrial sector, something like this. And in the place of, this is the company, right? So I'll just change it to company as well. Company. Okay, as you can see, I have done a small mistake. Okay, everywhere I have taken the caps lock, but here I have chosen, you know, the first letter itself as a caps and the rest of the small, that you need to avoid it. So I'm just rechanging it, that industrial sector. Okay, so I have got these images. Now the point is that whenever you are trying to create the report, the first tip which I told you is the proper alignment and the proper spaces and the proper visual dimensions. That is the first one. And the second one is that please make sure that you do not leave huge white spaces or huge empty spaces in your report. That really looks awkward. As you can see that earlier I had some space left. So what I have done here, I have increased the card size and I made sure that my complete page is full. Okay, that it looks very full. So now the next one is that I have to avoid white spaces. I have to see my alignments and the dimensions. And the next one is that the rounded corners. Whenever a visual is having a rounded corners, it looks very neat, simple. For example, if you have some, what happens if you have a sharp corners? It doesn't create some, I mean, there is nothing wrong in having the sharp edges, but rather than having a sharp edges, when we have a rounded corners, the picture looks very beautiful. So that's the only reason. So now the next one is the border and the shadows that I have used for each of my visual. I have used the border also, I have used the shadow also. If you have observed, the border, I'm maintaining the same point as 12 in every visual, right? So now coming to the next one is the color theme and the color theme which we are using. Do not use, you know, red, green, pink, yellow, orange, purple, okay, maroon, red, white. So don't mix all these things. Have a proper theme, all visuals in one line, all visuals in one particular color, all the titles in one particular color, same font size, same font style, background color is different and the visual colors is different. That will look very attractive actually. So now I'm choosing up the next information here. So let me choose something called as stacked bar chart. So you, in this stacked bar chart, what I'm trying to do, I'm choosing some information called as let me choose industrial sector here, and I, from each industrial sector, how much I have got it, that total sum I will choose it. So for example, I'm choosing total sales. Okay, so total sales for each industrial sector. So this is the one thing. And if I want to format it, yeah, I can easily format this one. It looks very interesting. Okay, so I have got like this. You can create or you can change the color, it depends upon you. As I cannot see my y-axis information, I can go and change it to bold. I'm making sure that it is looking very much attractive. Okay, so something like this, right? So this is one visual. And another one, if I would like to show, is I have got sales by industrial sector, and another visual is very similar to this. Now I have got sales by industrial sector. Now what I'm trying to do, I'm showing the profit by industrial sector. Okay, so I'm making sure that everything is aligned properly. In the place of sales, let me choose profit here. So I'm choosing profit for industrial sector, as we have got some negative values also. So my dear viewers, creating a design, okay, creating a dashboard, it should be very interesting and very interactive. If you see here, if I'm choosing any country, for example, Australia, you can see that every information in every visual is getting changed. So the Power BI report or dashboard that we are preparing should be interactive, something like this, where the client can interact with the report and understand the report or understand the business, what exactly they have. Okay, so these are the few design tips that we have to maintain when we are preparing some Power BI report that we convert it into dashboard later on. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.